Yes, it finally works!
This motor type might be the most important one for our electrical future, simply because they nowadays pretty much always get used in electric vehicles. I mean, even my EV comes with such a motor. They are called PMSM, which stands for Permanent Magnet Synchronous Motor. And even though they are super awesome, I'm kind of late to make a video about them. The reason for that though is that they only recently started popping up to buy for the everyday person. And let's not forget that they are quite expensive. So in this video, let me show you why they're awesome, what makes them tick, and why you should consider using them in your next project instead of, for example, a BLDC motor. Let's get started! Ever wanted to build something that feels a bit futuristic? Well, now you can, using transparent flexible PCBs and my sponsor JLCPCB. They offer 85% transparent PCBs, which are lightweight, bendable, and compatible with standard SMT assembly. Plus, they are surprisingly affordable and perfect for wearables, light-up devices, or any project where design meets function. If that sounds great to you, then click the link below and try out their transparent PCBs, because new users get $70 in coupons when signing up on JLCPCB. Now to get started, it is clear that my big PMSM here is quite a beast with a power rating of 5000 watts, and this power usually gets utilized for e-bikes or similar. In fact, you see such motors pretty much only when it comes to higher power applications, like moving people around. But wait a minute, I also got an e-bike here, but this one uses a BLDC motor. And truth be told, I have BLDC motors laying around the most, because they're relatively easy to control with an ESC, and they can be powerful as well. Which is why I used them before in an electric skateboard or a drone build. And when having a look at these two motor types side by side, then they do look kind of similar on the outside. So you know what, let's give it a shot and simply hook up an ESC, which is designed to drive BLDC motors, up to my PMSM. And yes, this actually seems to work pretty well, and the motor does create a decent amount of torque. So did I get scammed and this is just a beefy BLDC motor? Well, to find that out, we have to take a closer look at the output voltages of the two motor types on the oscilloscope. Now when spinning the BLDC motor with an electric dual, then we can see a three-phase voltage that looks very trapezoidal. The reason for that is the inner structure of the BLDC motor, whose magnets and windings are positioned in such a way that they create this shape. And no, this is not necessarily a bad thing, because this inner structure and thus voltage shape gets optimally utilized while driving the motor. As I showed before, for that we use an ESC, which basically connects one motor phase to the supply voltage, one to ground, and lets one floating. And by changing which coil gets powered through six different steps, we create a rotating magnetic field, and thus the motor spins. So if we look at the oscilloscope while the ESC is doing its thing, we can see similar trapezoidal shapes from before, meaning the ESC and BLDC motor are nicely compatible. But when moving over to the PMSM however, then we can very easily spot a big difference on the oscilloscope while rotating its shafts. Because this time we are working with a very beautiful sinusoidal three-phase voltage. Once again, the reason for this shape is the inner construction of the motor with its magnets and coil windings. And I think you can easily see the difference, especially when looking at the magnets of the rotors. However, since they're both still quite similar, you can drive a PMSM with an ESC. But as you might already have guessed, they're not 100% compatible, and thus there's room for improvement. So instead, we need a sine wave controller, like this beast here, which is a 4-driver one that can handle up to 3000 watts. Now hooking this thing up to my PMSM was pretty straightforward, because you can match colors and this connector here only fits one way. But let me tell you that the documentation for this thing was an assortment of thrown together PDF files. So I had no idea why after powering everything up, nothing happened. And the communication via the given Bluetooth module was also not possible. By the way, the Bluetooth app was probably the most sketchy app I ever had to install on my phone. But anyway, eventually I realized that you have to connect this orange key wire to the supply voltage. And to dictate how fast this motor should go, we need to inject a voltage between 0 and 5 volts on this green-white accelerator wire. To do that, I got myself such an e-bike throttle, and after wiring everything up and spending quite a bit of time to fiddle around with all the settings, I ultimately got the motor to spin. But apparently my power supply was too weak, which is why I switched over to an e-bike battery pack for power, and that pretty much solved all problems. So finally time to have a look at the voltage waveforms of this controller. And oh boy, this all does not really resemble any sine waves at first sight. However, when having a closer look, then we can see that the controller is using the SPWM technique, which basically reconstructs a sine wave with a PWM signal by varying its duty cycle. This should mean the current flowing through the coils is sinusoidal. And yes, that is definitely the case. And if you're curious, we can also have a look at the flowing current when using an ESC, which is definitely not purely sinusoidal. But anyway, as you probably guessed, the sine wave controller is perfectly compatible with a PMSM and brings in some big advantages in comparison to an ESC with BLDC motor. Most important here is the more constant torque, higher efficiency, and low speed performance. For example, since the ESC only uses 6 steps for one magnetic rotation, the magnetic field and thus torque also features peaks and thus is not really constant, which you can actually feel when holding a slow moving BLDC motor. The sine wave controller does this a lot better by creating a super smoothly changing magnetic field, and thus it creates a more constant torque. I mean, you can actually hear this difference, because the motor is a bit louder when using an ESC in comparison to a sine wave controller at roughly around the same RPM. And since my sine wave controller and many others also use FOC, which stands for field oriented control, we also use the minimum amount of mandatory current to create the torque and thus make things way more efficient. But if you want to know more about that, then definitely check out my dedicated video about this topic. For now, it is important to note though that to use this technique, we need to know the exact position of the motor's rotor. And for that, my PMSM comes with this extra connector here. It connects to the inside of the motor, where we can find an encoder, which of course can tell us the exact position of the rotor. This not only makes FOC possible, but it also improves the low speed behavior, which common BLDC motors can have some problems with. And there you have it. Even though BLDC motors and PMSM appear quite similar, they do come with noticeable differences. And when getting back to the broader picture, including all motor types, then the induction motor is still the most popular one with quite a gap, mainly because it is easy to drive, cheap and robust. But then again, when looking at EVs, then PMSM dominate this market, because they're the most efficient type, and that is of course crucial when running on battery power. With that being said, I hope you enjoyed this introduction to PMSM. And the last remaining question now is what I should make with mine. Definitely let me know in the comment section. As always, thanks for watching, and don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Stay creative, and I will see you next time.